Come on, why? For that man, you don't do any wife. You ain't never heard nobody gay bust. Never. It don't bother you and it don't bother my wife. Huh? This is a game. And then all of a sudden, white lady sues you. And they slap on the coat. And 30 years later, they come back. Okay? Case is over. She wants to sue you again. You better run black folks well enough to know all that time all the black sisters don't know what to do. Where did you get the money? Oh, I define it. Some of y'all don't even know where your children are. You take over there and find your witches and bring them out and say, oh, let me tell you what it is to do. This is a game. But y'all buy. Buy. Booty. You're not buying booty. What's booty? Anybody know?
Treasure.
Huh?
Treasure. 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 Booty treasure. Is treasure.
It's the loot that the pirates take off
the ship. Treasure.
It's called booty. Yeah. And how I you got to find booty. When you ever been on a ship before? Thank you. Look at that booty. He just smiles to little hyenas. He said, the God made that booty. That's where the doo-doo is, nigga. How are you going to do that? The elephant got an ass 10 times bigger than yours, and ain't nobody in there. That's a fine ass.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
I got it.
So much. So much. You can't kill me. That's why you choose. Excuse me, when you're a little girl, you have a best friend? You remember their name? What was it? Huh? Yes, okay. What your mom was? Yeah, your mom paid the name, you paid the house note, the car note, buy your clothes, pay for you to go to school. But I'm your best friend because you can hear and that God gives you the thing is nothing. They always tell you what to do, your best friend don't say nothing. Mm. Don't be afraid. You only ever figured that out? My wife told me one day, she said, you're just spending more time with your oldest son than what? He's taking a strong dislike to you. I said, you can have that. Anything he sees is that he's going to take it out and shoot it next to
him. All right.
That's what you say on the house, Lord. And y'all get to you your last name, he better hope I don't take a strong dislike. When y'all call me the racist son, he's so crazy. I've been married 58 years.
Woo! Woo!
She wants to know how glad you did. You see him clap? I didn't see how happy. And I just said to her, I said, look, if you want this marriage to work, I don't care. My only child I remember their birthday is my oldest daughter. She's 58 years old. I've been married 58 years. Obviously, she was pregnant for me that marriage. And I said to her, if you want this to work, I don't care. I think I got the booty the first night. You didn't, you got it the second night. If you wanted to work, it ain't about love, and can you be loved? I'm safe with you, and you safe with me. That's what your mothers have for the baby. Lovability ain't got sex, nothing to do with it. Some of you black folks will be at some club this weekend. This weekend, some niggas at the table don't even know you. Sit here with Bobby Champagne. You don't think you're about to bust it. That's why you did it. Just go, nigga. Religion in the history of the planet. Paganism. Okay? That's what it was about. And you don't sit around and don't even know what they're doing. Somewhere, when you stop and just see, you can make a difference. The blueprint's already been set. Martin Luther King took on the mightiest nation in the history of planet Earth and brought it to a meeting with no guns. No hatred. That don't mean nothing to you. It's a game to play. Do you want me to feel the hatred? Somewhere, you, I go all over the world, I know how they feel about you, they're scared of you, because they know nobody in the history of planet Earth has ever survived this viciousness, and they still see your love. No slave has ever been hired by the slave owner to fix their food and take care of their baby. They can see it, but you can't see it. This is a game. Someone go to school. I live in a country where they got good schools and bad schools. Go all over the world. And then all of a sudden, Russia shoots something up, and you didn't know it until they told you now how stupid they are. The Chinese, they told you how stupid they were. They went over there in Vietnam, you know, and the Chinese come over that hill. The Vietnamese war is still going on. We signed a truce. We never ended the war. That's what it's about. Why? The richest country in the world is North Korea. Huh? And they don't tell you that. Why? 98% of the tungsten on this planet is located in Korea. Compton just been there for millions of years. It's like Mappy Hair. If they find out Mappy Hair killed cancer, they can put their locks on their cat. Wife's gonna say, well, come here, come on, everybody don't breathe. They never needed it. You put it with different metals and it goes through the chief utility change. They didn't need it. Somewhere. And then they had gone off 2 days and told all the first responders something gonna happen to King in 2 days. And when it happened, everybody got orders to take him to this one hospital. And if he come there and he's not dead, y'all know what to do. And they spit on him and did all that stuff and then they smothered him to death. Martin Luther King. And somewhere when you stop in fact, you look at this Trump stuff. Everybody in the world laughing at you. They're laughing at Trump. He is probably one of the homeless men. Holding up the, now y'all can't see it in the magazine. What magazine is that? You see? The Economist, right?
Yes, sir.
That is one of the most powerful white boy books on the planet. What's on the cover? They got Trump with lipstick on and Putin with them lipstick mark on. It's a game thing. Huh? And then the one that y'all will never see here is the hottest thing going on in Europe as we sit here now. It's been going for 3 days this year. Putin in the back of them, both of them naked. Putin's in the back of them. Okay? That's what they're talking about. While y'all sitting here scared of this punk. I'm scared of him. He's a shadow. And one thing about a shadow, when the sun goes down, the shadow disappears. And if you go home tomorrow and look at the shadow in your house, the shadow is bigger than your house. But it's not real. And y'all scared of that? Scared of him?
No.
Something's wrong with you. I mean, this man is a stone fool. Huh? A stone fool. Ignorant. Ain't got nothing going for him. He never had no money. All that crap about he's a millionaire. Well, tell him, show us the money. This is the game. White folks, I call up and say, how much you make? I made 10 million last year. What? Yeah, I made 10 million. How can I prove it? You can't, cracker. And they're going to tell me, cracker is a racial slur. Thank you, brother. Somewhere, you get the love. Somewhere, I used to work the river, Mississippi River, during floods. And We were sitting eating lunch, my brother and I, at Red Cross lunch, and the folks working on the levee, this white dude was sitting there eating lunch, and the back of his neck started turning red. So a redneck quacker, what do you think? You think that's a racial slur? My neck turned red, but you can't see it. Okay? That's right before you have a sudden stroke. It gets red as a beet, and the skin is dry, and it looks like a white soda cracker if you put it in water and let it dry out. That's where that came from. Okay? Honky, honky, honky. What do honky mean? See, prostitution was the benefit for white men. What do you mean, black men? Man, I came over as a slave. She didn't have a job, and I didn't have a job. And we had booty every day. But there was no money. Okay, let our slavery's over, and prostitution is the benefit for white men. Okay? And so here's what happened. If the governors from around the world is meeting here, or the brain surgeon is meeting here, the whole house is about 45 miles from here because there ain't nobody seeing it. And it's usually run by black folks. And so when they pull up, black guy giving you honk hard. Uh-huh. That's where the word honking comes from. Okay, and they got you believing all this old crazy stuff, you know. So somewhere, when you stop and think, and these rich white folk, they just think I know everything. And I don't want to leave anybody. Damn right, I know everything. Well, Mr. Gregory, you just want to know something. What do you want to know? We'd like to know about Malaysian Airlines. Malaysian Airlines? Do you know Malaysian Airlines have 192 different planes that land there every day? And nobody asks, well, what they got for them? What kind of companies they got? You ever bought something made in Malaysia? Okay, then why are planes going there? Malaysian Airlines is where the rich freaks from all over the world go to have no children. That's what it's about. And you mean, ain't nobody ever told you why them airlines is there? Malaysian Airline, okay? The one that disappeared. When you go home tonight, Google, where is Malaysian Airline? And just look and put in, is at D.Gregory Garcia, and they still alive. And you sitting out here with your mighty arm, and you think an airplane with all them satellites up there can track a roach? But didn't know where the plane was. So somewhere, so those are the things that you have to do, is understand. Now quickly, let me show you something here now. Because I told Trump's people, you know, that niggas know voodoo. But I said, I got a cousin, and if he don't stop, these shoes will be too big for him. You know? These shoes will be too big for him. And these pants will fit. So somewhere, here's what you do. Stop believing in all this stuff they tell you. 300 years ago, America sent their scientists to Colombia to check out hieroglyphics. We didn't know how to break it down, but we know we was getting close. So they went there and took pictures of all the stuff on the wall and all the good pictures and stuff. And 150 years later, they cracked hieroglyphics. And here's what it said. White man, one day, the white lady wanted to be your children, but you doing ours. 300 years ago, cocaine wasn't called the white lady. Now, the number one drug out state in America right now as we sit here is Utah. Okay? They got you believing this base. Utah! Huh? They join the church when they're their mama's guy. Ain't too many poor folks there. But people have always seen things and knew stuff. And sometimes they try to project and take it. Somewhere, the number two state that's drugged out, Vermont. Okay, and since this morning, so now while we sitting here, 81% of all the OD deaths are white folks. 81%. And then at midnight it goes up. Why? Because your brain tells you every day, your heart, to keep beating. They got heroin out here, they put it in the white neighborhood that wipes that part of your brain out. So you don't get the lessons from your brain. And that's why after midnight it goes up to 91% of white folks on duty. There's a thing out here that if you just leave it alone, vengeance is mine. Dr. George Washington Carver, never was around white folks until he went to Tuskegee. Because when slavery ended, they had to find a way to keep them. And so they called them body snatchers. And so they kidnapped him, his daddy, and his mom. And he fell off the buckboard and they didn't realize until they got to the house. And they went, no, we're going to get him tomorrow morning. And they went there and some white folks had found him and took him to this place where white folks could come and adopt. And that's what happened to him. He went to Iowa. Iowa didn't have no blacks. They don't get no school system for one. So he went to integrated schools, grade school, high school, college, grad school. And then when he went to Tuskegee, was the first time he saw Negroes. And they thought he was gay. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They thought he was gay. Why?
He was castrated.
His high-pitched voice.
Castrated.
And his non-associated with women. And he would have rather 110 years ago to think he was gay than know that white folks had adopted him, castrated him, because he couldn't have nothing to do with their daughter. That's what happened to him. Now, this is how the universe works. He invented. Okay? He told Ford, that Ford would bring millions of dollars to Tuskegee because of him, because of his mind. And he told Ford have never got credit for inventing the car because he ain't invented nothing. The D.Gregory brothers in Massachusetts invented the car. Anything you see about the Ford family, they said they created the plant, which means you can make more than one car. Henry Ford was sitting there, and George Washington Carver said, then Ford, this is my research. And if you take this and give it to your engineers, it's about the plants. And if they do what this says, you can produce more than one car. Okay, that's all over the world. Mass production is called the plant. Because of George Washington Carver. But then, so I'm saying, when you have mass production, you have mass layoffs. That's what's called the Depression. Mass layoffs. The white folks was committing suicide and doing all of that. And then another thing that happened. Another thing that happened. The number one heart attack, it comes from the soil. Did you hear me? Soil. Because you wasn't supposed to eat soil. George Washington invented it. That's why God said, vengeance is mine. Leave it alone. If you said to God, he wouldn't have done it. But the universal God, I'm not talking about the church, I'm talking about the universal God that don't cut you no slack at all. And if you look at all that Egypt stuff y'all be running through, all you gotta do is look at your nose, that's where the pyramid come from. Look at your nose, that's a pyramid. Folk go to Egypt so they can sleep under the pyramid, spend billions of dollars a year. All you got to do is sleep on your back in the pyramid, and you're sleeping under the pyramid. The thing is safe. Okay? And so somewhere, when you understand this, okay? And so somewhere, the number one cause of heart attacks is cancer, lung cancer. Soy, more white folks and a couple of black folks, vegetarians, are the leading folks that die from lung cancer. Not cigarettes, lung cancer. That's what this is about. And that universal God, it don't talk. It don't say nothing. You got children, a child can be 2 days old, and you in one room talking to somebody, and you know if that child is feeling good or bad because of the vibration. The vibration. So, and so when you start to think about what's fixing to happen, now let me tell you something here. And if y'all don't get this book, because they ain't telling you the truth, but they say it to you. Here it is, right here. Right there. That's what they scared of. Okay? That thing is on its way to you. I don't want to come here and lie to you. I don't lie to you. Okay? Now listen to that. Look at that. See it a little bit by anybody. They've been tracking that since 1930. Okay? Back then it circled this planet once a year, not circling every day. Mm. And that's what Trump is about. He don't know it. It's to keep your mind off of this. Because you knew what this MDC people killed their children, their family. This is what this is. And when you look here, that was like 20 years ago. They took that picture today, and I'm sure they got it, but they're going to put it on a magazine. That planet Earth now is the size of a grain of sand. Mm. And like I said, it used to circle once a year, and now it's circling every day, and they know it's about to hit. But y'all don't feel nothing. You don't feel nothing at all. You old folks have been around old folks. You know, old folks didn't lose their memory. Huh? You're losing your memory now because that vibration from that is wiping that part of your brain out. So this is what this is. It's from somewhere. And then have you heard, wait, I think I have it here. Have you heard that here? Did I say, what year did I say they started tracking that? 1930, right? And this was, what paper was that? That was two of these papers, right? February 22nd. Now, right underneath here, when I'm on the rug, no, they can't see that. No, no, they don't need to see it. You won't tell them. Okay? Front page, 2 days ago, of the USA Today. Keep on.
A group of NASA scientists proposed a new definition of what constitutes a planet, possibly opening the door for Pluto to return to its former status.
Now, most folks don't know what that means. In yesterday's USA Today, did y'all see the story about them seven planets heading here? Now, they didn't tell you what it was, but those of us that know, that's what they were talking about. The front page of the USA Today, yesterday, they had that story in there. So somewhere is here, you talk about draining the swamp, right? This is the front page of Newsweek this week, the one that's on the stand now. What do you think?
This swamp has no drain.
No drain. Huh? They ain't talking about the, here's all the stuff that's coming out now about this, but they're not telling you what it really is. And how many of you older folks remember the Orson Welles? Hear that radio show about the earth coming to an end? Do you know people start killing their children, wiping out their family? And they know if they told the truth, and that's what Trump is there for, to have you talking about that craziness, that craziness. And I love this picture here. Newsweek. Look at that. And y'all scared of that? Please. Now, here's another thing I'm going to show you. So you leave here. You don't have to believe. You can leave here. Now, he was a vegetable.
Yes.
He died of a NASA's eye. Now, look at this picture here. For you young folks, that's me, I'll be honest with you. Okay? The gun on his hip, so that's the one he used to kill the cop. The rifle is the one he
mail order. You know, you're going to kill the president and you're going to get a gun through mail order? Now, I want you to look real good over there. When y'all get on Google Life Magazine, you see the date on it?
Can you see February 21st, 1964.
Now, y'all Google that, and here's the reason. Look at it, those of you in the front, the back, they have the video, they'll tell you. Look at the shadow, you will see it up front. Look at the, look at his body shadow. Is the shadow going frontward or back? Can you see it? Back, right? Okay, for you folks back there, they just validated. Now look at his nose shadow. Is it going frontward or back? Forward. The universal God don't have shadows one going one way. This is a dub picture. At that time, Life Magazine was the number one magazine on the planet. Look at the newspaper, sit up there, because you can see it's a different head on the body. And that's what made people believe what they told them all over the world. What they didn't tell you, 14 people was killed that day. It was shooting everywhere. And if y'all saw the two trains, the three trains, that was up on the viaduct, okay? That was E. Howard Hunt. The other one's code name was Raoul. And the third one was Frank Sturgis. Raoul, that's Willie Harrison's son. He's the father of Willie Harrison, the one that you'll see in the movies. And so when you sit and you look at this, and when the truth come out, they don't even know how to deal with it at all. Some of them. Now, this never ran in an American newspaper. This is about what happened in South Carolina. What's the headline say?
It says, U.S. to fast track $29 million to help Charleston shooting victims.
Now, The shooting took place on the 17th. 2 days later, on the 19th, the Justice Department fast-tracked a check for how much?
$29 million.
And who did it go to?
The Charleston shooting victims' family.
Did you hear anything about one of the biggest stories on the planet, and nobody in America? Why was they paying them $26 million? Because something didn't happen. Okay. But you believed it. And I said, well, okay, how come I didn't hear those sirens? How come they didn't show me the fuel to show me one fuel? This is what the game is about. The marathon, thank you, brother. The marathon in Boston. I ran the marathon 5 times. And if you want to kill somebody at the marathon, you go to where it starts. It's about 80,000 people there. If you run the marathon, your friend's gonna come in and everything. That. So why did they not blow up the stuff until 2 hours after the marathon race was over? Because had they blown it up at the beginning, the marathon would have ceased, because all your best runners in the world would have been dead. And now, they sent 2 FBI agents in to do the investigation. Nobody could let no information out until they finish doing the investigation. What did they hide? What paper is that?
This is Global Research News.
Okay, and what's it say?
It says FBI agents killed in Virginia were investigating the Boston bombing.
Now you see what this is? They were killed. They were the ones, the lead investigators. But they don't know what's some stuff out here now they can't stop. Okay, and I think I told you earlier about Nelson Rockefeller. Did y'all know what I said? Come on, did you remember? Mm-hmm. Had his son killed. Sent him on a business trip and the camera was aiming. Okay? What's it say?
Son of Nelson Rockefeller was murdered by a tribe in New Guinea.
Okay? This is who they are. And y'all think before they rich and all that, but they got something going for them, they ain't got nothing going for them. When JFK got back to D.C. that evening, his brain was missing, okay? Now, how the president gonna be shot with all the folks that rushed in there to preserve the evidence and his brain was missing, okay? Now, what does that say?
It says, JFK's missing brain, missing amid fears, it was stolen in...
The military anymore.
Okay.
All that you can punch up. Okay? All that you can punch up. And somewhere, when you look and see what this is, and so when you look around, the number one business in this country today, more than dope, more than prostitution, is organ stealing. Okay? And all these drive-bys. You as a mother, father, you're so upset, you never think of cutting them open and the organs are gone. Okay? That's the game. And they made a big bust in New Jersey, in Newark. I couldn't believe it. That's the first time they arrested almost 100 people. It wasn't on black folks. In Newark? No black folks? Huh? What's that say there?
It says organ failure, the arrest of rabbis who trafficked body parts.
It was school teachers, huh? Professors, and the number one lead on organ stealing is John Hopkins.
It says two state legislators and several rabbis were among more than 40 people arrested yesterday in New Jersey.
And y'all can't feel nothing? But you know how to dance. You know how to cook barbecue. I think I got a bigger one, but I'm not going to go for it. But I will show you that. And you got to explain what that is. That's a list. A list of what all can sell for. So if I want to run in and buy me an ankle, what's it called? Hear me now, listen. Just like you go to the butcher shop, if I want an ankle, what's it called?
300 and what? No, 8.
I want a kneecap, what's it called? Just look at the knee, they got the tag there.
Is it $8? No. Okay.
You didn't go to private school. No, what I'm saying is, somewhere, and so there's people out here now that are not going to tolerate what they're doing, and we're going to do something about it. And we're talking about no guns or nothing. New York Times story. Read it, it's in New York Times.
The methodology.
No, it said New York Times.
Yes, sir, it says New York Times.
Okay, then what do it say?
1.5 million missing black men.
Missing? They do it every night and you don't know a damn thing about it. Every night. But you, anything is cracker changing. Okay? But then I'm going to tell you this. We have to go in and dig this up. Read it again.
1.5 million missing black men.
Okay? Every night. And you sitting here now, somewhere. And so again, here's the big news there again. What's it say?
National black market body parts being exposed in Michigan.
Okay, being exposed in Michigan. And you heard about what happened in
Flint?
Flint? The water? Okay, that's genocide. Nobody called it genocide. So the one black woman that couldn't get the government to investigate, she carried her case to federal court. Did any of y'all know what I'm fixing to say? A week later, they came in the house and shot her 5 times in the head, and the slave was visited. Did any of y'all know about that? Oh, you got this movie. The engineer, the water engineer in Flint, would have had to come in and testify. They went in his house and shot him in the head dead. Right here, they're going to tell you about Russia and North Korea. It's happening right here, but you don't know nothing about it. So somewhere when you stop and think about where this is going, here, I want you to hear this. It's a brilliant doctor, researcher. What's it say?
Crime linked to pollution.
Did you hear that? Crime, listen to me, but you blame it on you because listen to what this doctor says.
Polluted water can cause brain damage that turns ordinary people into violent criminals.
You hear that? Says. And you think it's you. They put in the water, huh? They put in the air. You see them trails up there, it's called chemtrails.
Trails, yep.
And they got chemicals set on the plane and they make it and blow it down and aim it into your neighborhood.
Okay. Like
but you sit and want to blame it on yourself. This is the LA Times. I want you to hear this real good. What's it saying there?
It says Los Angeles police differ sharply with prosecutors on arrest.
Now this is the Los Angeles police. Now read the first sentence of time.
It says, reflecting confusion that has characterized the city's response to the violence that some 10 days ago, prosecutors and the police are giving wildly different.
Now listen to what they said. Here's what the prosecutor
reports on the number of riot-related arrests. Police officials said today that they had arrested 18,000.
Now this is the cop, hold on. This is the cop said in the March riots, we have arrested 18,000 people. But what did the prosecutors say?
It said they arrested 18,000 people from Wednesday night, April 29th. The day the riots began through this morning, the prosecutors say they could not.
Really slow, Steve, right now?
Yes, sir.
Prosecutors said what?
They could not account for as many as 10,000 of those.
Did you see what happened? This is in the police station. 10,000 people is missing. They shipped them up to Oregon, Bootsman, where they took the organs. And y'all sit here and can't feel nothing and warn about this and warn about that. And it was Ron Brown when they said, and listen to this university. Who's the lead? What's the headline say?
UCLA sued over its wheeled body program.
They sued and won. Okay?
Families claim university disposed of cadavers in an undignified manner.
They still didn't know what they were doing, but it went to court. Now, this picture here, this come out of Ferguson, Missouri. And that's the picture that went around the world, okay? When they showed him coming out that cigar shop, remember that? Huh? Then Google it tonight. He come out, he had on flip-flops and short pants. 15 minutes later, he laying dead with Nikes and long pants on. Okay? And y'all don't see that? Because the white folks show you, and you so prone to that, even you niggas with your fist ball up and talking that crap. You already had your head messed up. And they can show you that, and all you got to do is pull it. And so Ron Brown owes to his brain crashed into the ocean. The white folks that did the autopsy brought the pictures to me and showed me where they shot him in the head. That's a bullet hole in his head. It never was the plane wreck in the ocean that they said it was. Here's the tail of the plane. That looks like it's in the ocean. This is what they do every day. And y'all sit around talking all that crazy talk and want to know who won the football game. And so, how many people is missing? Black men?
1.5 million, sir.
And then another paper came out of the Washington Post and told you where they are. And they're in that plant right above us. Now, what's the headline say? This is Washington Post. What's the headline say?
It says, today's Earth is a little less lonely. NASA announces the discovery of Kepler, 420.
That's what they are.
And potentially have
stop looking for them. That's where they are. And there's no way you can get there. Why can't you say, well, how can you get there? I know how to get there, but I'm not going to tell you. Somewhere. And if we wind down, I want you to hear this. I see you black folk take education as the answer. Education is the answer. Okay? This is a story about the 9 most powerful rich men on the planet. It happened in Chicago. They gathered at Edgewater Beach Hotel. Listen what it says. 1923.
This is the rise and fall of 9 rich men. Money as we know it is neutral. It is neither evil nor bad. It is what we do with it that will make a difference in our lives. I read about this illustration recently. A popular story recounts a meeting that may have taken place in the Edgewater Beach Hotel in Chicago in 1923.
1923. Now hear this and read it slowly.
Yes, sir.
These ain't church chairs. These are the nine most powerful white men on the planet. Number one,
Charles Schwab, president of the world's largest independent steel company.
That's U.S. Steel. Okay, number two,
Samuel Insull, president of the world's largest utility company.
Number three,
Howard Hobson, president of the largest gas firm.
Number four,
Arthur Cutting, the greatest wheat speculator.
Number five,
Richard Whitney, president of the New York Stock Exchange.
Number six,
Albert Fall, member of the president's cabinet.
A billionaire. Number seven,
Leon Frazier, president of the Bank of International Settlements.
Number eight,
Jesse Livermore, the greatest speculator in the stock market.
Number nine,
Ivar Kruger, head of the company with the most widely distributed securities in the world.
In the world, that's nine of them. And then somebody said, 25 years, hey, man, let's see what they are now. Where are they now?
What happened to these powerful and rich men 25 years later? Charles Schwab had died in bankruptcy, having lived on borrowed money for 5 years before his death.
Number two,
Samuel Insull had died virtually penniless after spending some time as a fugitive from justice.
Number three,
Howard Hobson became insane.
Number four,
Arthur Cutting died overseas, broke.
Number five,
Richard Whitney had spent time in a mental asylum.
Number six.
It don't give me number six.
Huh?
It doesn't give me number six.
Okay, do you have a number?
Yes, sir, somewhere.
Oh, no, don't worry about it. All of them died penniless and broke, and the last three of them that committed suicide. So y'all think it's money, huh? You think it's money. You want your children to go to school, get a good education, you make money. That works with the Catholic Church, the Baptist Church, but there's a universal God that will give a damn about your money, and there it is. Okay? There it is. Okay. And so, here's where we go. What we're looking at now is that plan. Okay? There's a group of NASA scientists, I might have said this earlier, that formed their own information bank to tell the world that the money they spent on the space program was to chase this thing. And here's a story of 74
top NASA scientists murdered in the past 10 years.
Okay.
What's going on?
This is the biggest cover up in the history of the planet. Mm. They was going to tell you what happened. And so this year, here, I'm going to do this on the planet. This was from the Chicago Tribune. Headlines, Chicago Tribune. Listen.
It says, FBI memo, use mob against D.Gregory.
And they got a picture of me and Mover before the FBI, Johnson, that ran the FBI in Chicago. I got a copy of the memo before they did. I'm the one that called the president. You want to see something? It didn't make no paper but this, but that D.Gregory been planning on killing Hoover, and it went all over the world. That's what you're looking at when you look, and you got to look at it. I look at it, not because I believe in it, to look at the crack in the fact. That's all. There it is, front page. And then I read that first paragraph. Here's what Hoover said. FBI said what?
The late J. Edgar Hoover ordered the Chicago office of the FBI to develop measures to...
Slow.
Yes, sir. The late J. Edgar Hoover ordered the Chicago office of the FBI to develop measures to neutralize black comedian D.Gregory.
Now, that's the word they use for kill.
Yes, sir.
Neutralize. Me. Huh? So I called the thugs in Chicago. And said, I got something you probably getting it later, but you call your boss and tell him. Some niggas you can mess with and some you can't. I'm one of the niggas you can mess with. And you'd be better off getting on the ladder with a hammer trying to knock the sun out of the sky. Than messing with one regular fellow and not a kid. That's what it's about. Go. hard to walk around. Can you be scared to put football and hit your head all the time, y'all? And so, is that that? I need you. I want y'all to hear this. What happened to Kid? This is Daniel who we're not paying to get. What's it say?
After action report, civil disorder operation.
Slow up.
Lantern spike.
That's their code name. Mm-hmm. And it said what?
It says Commanding General, U.S. Army Intelligence Command.
This is them, the military. Okay? Our Lord Hallelujah. That's the ones. Don't listen to this now.
The attached after action report covering the civil disorder operation Lantern Spike, March 28th through 12th, April.
They sent me as March the 28th through 12th to April. And they knew they was going to shoot King on the 4th, but they were going to stay there to see if anybody happened to see something so they could kill them too. That's what this is about. And now, the last thing. Here's what happened to Trump, because it happened to me. That's the price list of what all can sell for.
Turn around here, yeah, this way, no, this way.
They got to tag whatever you want, that's there, okay? Now, I'll leave you with this. I need, brother, would you come on? Yes. Now, I want to show you something. And if I didn't show it, you probably believe what they told me. Now, you know. Come on. Yes. Brother, you come on. Come on. I want you all to see this. It's sat over there. And open this up.
It's sat over there?
Oh, okay. Now, open it up. So everybody in the room can see. Okay? This is a gorilla who they say you look like. Huh? Now watch this now. Is it up right? Yeah. Now show it up real so people can see it. See that gorilla? Yeah. And they convince you that's you. Gorillas got short legs and long bodies. Black folks have long legs and short bodies. Okay? Now, if I took all the white men in this town and got them naked, and black men get naked and the gorilla get naked, who looks like a gorilla? White men got hair all over their body? Niggas ain't got nothing all over their body. Huh? Look at the gorilla got short legs and long bodies. Now, look at the gorilla's, some of you didn't see them, look at the gorilla's lips, they razor blade thin. Gorilla got no big lips, huh? But yet they can convince you that's you.
That's them.
Look at it. That gorilla got little bitty lips, you can hardly see. But they told you this is you. So what y'all need to do and ask God to forgive you is go to the zoo tomorrow. And go to the gorilla cage and carry you some peanuts and say, yeah, cracker. Thank you much. Thank you much.
D.Gregory, round of applause. We love you. Give it up. Give it up, Houston. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. Thank you for gracing us with your presence, my brother. You talk about Black History Month. You got walking, talking, living, breathing Black history right here with us. Brothers and sisters, thank you so much for coming. If you would like to meet or greet
ladies that are alive, if there's a rich priest from all over the world called to that one too, that one to God. Believe me, ain't nobody ever told me why the hell I'm sitting there. Malaysian ally. Okay, the one that disappeared, when you go home tonight, Google, what is Malaysian ally? And just look at the end, because the end of our season, and they still alive. And you sit down here with your mighty lion, and you make a river. You make an airplane with all the satellites up there to try to run it, but you don't want to fight us. So somewhere, so both of the things that you have to do is understand. Now quickly, let me show you something here now, because I told the Trump speaker, you know, that niggas are going to do it. And I said, I'm not sorry, and if he don't stop, he's shooting the big one. He's shooting the big one, and he's fighting the big one. Stop believing in all this stuff they carry. 300 years ago, America sent their scientists to Colombia to check out biophysics. We didn't know about a working guy, but we knew we were getting caught. So they went there and took pictures of all the stuff on the wall and all the new pictures of stuff. And he even said, one man, one day, the white man is going to do to your children what you're doing in ours 200 years ago, cocaine, what it called the white man. Now, the number one 12-hour state in America, right now, we sit here, is Utah. Okay? They got two people that face Utah. Huh? They go to church for many miles down. They took the poor folks there. The people have only seen the times and the new stuff. And sometimes they try to get content. So, the number two state is drug out, drug out. Okay? And since this morning, to now, while we're sitting here, 81% of all the OB deaths are white. 81%. And then, at midnight, it goes up. Why? Because your brain tells you every day your heart to keep beating. You got hair about you, you put it in my neighborhood and rub that whole little brain out. And you don't get the message from your brain. And that's why after midnight it goes up to 99% of what it's for me. There's a thing out here. And he is leaving alone. Vengeance is mine. Like the George Washington car. George Washington car. Never left out of my foot until he went to Tuskegee. Because when slavery ended, they had to find a way to keep them. And so they called them body snatchers. And so they kidnapped him, his daddy, and his mom. And he fell from the buckboard, and they didn't realize until they got to the house. And they went to the meeting tomorrow. And they went there, and some white folks had found it, and took it to this place where white folks could come and adopt it. And that's what happened to him. He went to Iowa. Iowa didn't have no blacks. They don't get no students except for Joanna. So he went to him and went to school. Grade school, high school, college, grad school. And then when he went to Tuskegee, it was the first time he saw Negroes. And they thought he was gay. Did they all understand? They thought he was gay. Why? His high pitched voice. And it's not associated with women. And he met a brother 110 years ago that think he was gay, then know him white folks that adopted him, castrated him, because he couldn't have nothing to do with their daughter. That's what happened to him. Now let's look how the universe works. He invented, okay? He told Ford, I mean Ford, Ford would bring millions of dollars to Tuskegee because of him, because of his mind. And he told Ford, Ford had never got credit for getting a call because he didn't get for any minute, nothing, to do Ray Brothers in Massachusetts and send it to call. And he came, you see, got a foreign parent, they said they created the planet.
which means you can make more than one car. Henry Ford was sitting there, and George Washington Carver said, "Henry Ford, this is my research. And if you take this and give it to your engineers, it's about the planet. And if they do what this says, you can produce more than one car." Because that's all over the world, mass production is called the planet. Because of George Washington Carver. But then, it's my thing, when you have mass production, you have mass layoff. That's what's called the depression. Mass layoff. The white folks was committing suicide and doing all of that, and then another thing that happened. Another thing that happened. The number one attack, it comes from the stomach. You eat the stomach. Of course, you're not supposed to eat the stomach. George Washington called it a dinner. That's why God said, "Vengeance is not leaving alone." But he said to God, "You want to die?" But the universal God, I'm not talking about the church, I'm talking about the universal God that don't put you no slack at all. If you look at all that deep stuff that we run into, all that is what you know is that's where the pyramid come from. Look at your nose, that's a pyramid. Walk for the east to where you sleep on the pyramid, spin it. Hidden for thousands of years. All you got to do is sleep on your back. In the pyramid, and you sleep under the pyramid. But that is shame. Okay? And so somewhere when you understand this, okay? Because so, the number one cause of heart attacks is cancer, lung cancer. So more white folks and brown black folks, vegetarians, are the lead folks that die from lung cancer. Not cigarettes, lung cancer. That's what this is about. And that universal God, you know, it don't talk, it don't say nothing. You got children, the child can be 2 days old, and you in one room talking to somebody, and you know that child is doing good or bad because of the vibration. The vibration. So, and so when we start reflecting on what's fixing to happen, now let me tell you something here. Y'all may be a book of man talking the truth, but they say it to you. Here it is, right? That's what they scared of. Okay? That thing is going to make it. I don't want to come back and rob you. I don't want to. Now listen to that. Look at that.
Right?
Preparatory step. Now, right underneath here, from the whole amount of things in there. No, it needs to be you, what's that? Okay. Front page, 2 days ago, from USA Today, what's that say there? Listen now.
You know, could get planned status back, you define. Scientists still alive by war and emotion.
Really?
A group of NASA scientists proposed a new definition of what constitutes a planet, possibly opening the door for Pluto to return to its former status.
Now, look for what that means. In yesterday's USA Today, the Northeast story, by page 7,
Mm-hmm.
Now, they didn't tell you what it was, but told you what that number. That's what they were talking about. The front page of the USA Today, yesterday, they had that story in there. So someone is here, you talk about playing in the swamp, right? This is front page of the news with this week, and one is going to stand down.
This swamp has no drain.
No drain! Huh? They ain't talking about it. Here's all the stuff that's coming out now. About this, but they're not telling me what it really is. And only you older folks remember the Austin World did that radio thing about the earth coming to the end. You know, people are going to be killed, talking about the effect of that. And they know that they don't do that for their fault. Have you talked about that craziness? That craziness. And y'all scared, right? Now, here's another thing I'm doing. You need here, you gotta believe. You believe it. Now, Kennedy did not die in Dallas. I'm the only one. He was a veteran. He died with a massive honor. Now, look at this picture here. When we get up for that, we are the officer. Okay? The gun on his hip, and that's the one he used to kill the cop. The rifle is the one he nailed. He told me, you're going to kill the president, and you're going to get a gun to nail him. Now, I want you to look real good when y'all get home, Google Life Magazine. You see the date on it?
February 21st, 1964.
Now, y'all Google that, and here's the reason. Look at it, those of you in the front, the back, they have to be your okay. Look at the shadow, you see it up front. Look at the body shadow. Is the shadow going to front look or back? Can you see it? Back, huh? Then, when you go back there, they get it validated. Now look at his nose shadow. Is it going front or back? Boom! The universe of God don't have shadows, one going one way. This is a dull picture. At that time, Life Magazine was the number one magazine on the planet. Look at the newspaper, set up there, you can see it's a different head on the body. And that's what made people believe what they told them all over the world. What they didn't tell you, 14 people was killed that day. They were shooting everybody. And you saw the two trucks that was up on the rocks. Okay? That was E. Howard Hunt. The other one's called name was Raoul. And the third one was Frank Sterling. Raoul, that's Willie Harrison's son. He's the father of one of us. He runs the LC and the rules. And so when you see, when you look at this, and when the truth comes out, they don't even know how to deal with it at all. So, now, this is what ran in the American newspaper. This is about what happened in South Carolina. Look at the headline, sir.
It says the U.S. to fast track $29 million to help child shooting victims.
Now, the shooting took place on the 17th. 2 days later, on the 19th, the Justice Department fast track a check for how much?
$29 million.
And who did it go to?
The child shooting victims.
If you look at that, one of the biggest stories on the planet, and nobody in America, why would they pay an employee for something like that? Okay? But you believe it. And I said, well, okay, somebody here knows what I read. Operating certainly the future, certainly wants you. This is what the game is about. The nerve problem. Thank you, but the nerve problem. In Boston, I ran the marathon 5 times. And if you want to kill somebody at the marathon, you go to where it starts. It's about 8,000 people there. If you run the marathon, your friends are going to come in and everything. That, so why did they not blow up the stuff until 2 hours after the marathon race was over? Because had they blown it up at the beginning, the marathon would have ceased for all your best runners in the world would have been dead. And now, he sent 2 FBI agents in to do the investigation. Nobody could have no information out until they finished doing the investigation. What did they have? Who paid for that?
This is Global Research News.
Okay, and what's it say?
It says FBI agents killed in Virginia were investigating the Boston bomb.
Now you see, this is definitely. That was the one to lead the investigation. But they don't know what's going to stop out here now, they can't stop. Okay, like I told you earlier about what's going on. You don't know what I said? Come on, what you doing? Had his son kicked, sent him on a business trip and a cannibal baby. Okay? What did he say?
Son of Nelson Rockefeller was murdered by Schwabe and
D. Okay? This is who they are. You don't think the Lord is rich and all that crap. They got something going for them, they got nothing going for them. When JFK got back to D.C. that evening, his brain was missing. Okay? Now, how the president going to be shot with all the folks that rushed in there to preserve the evidence and his brain is missing? Okay? Now, what does that say?
It says JFK's missing brain, missing from the appears it was stolen in.
A little bit. All that you can point to, okay? All that you can point to is somewhere when you look, and see where this is. And so when you look around, the number one business in this country today, more than dope, more than prostitution, is all going to steal. Okay? Now we drive guys. You the mother problem, you're so upset. You never think of cutting open and they all just are gone. Okay? That's the game. And they made a big bust in the
$8.
Some of them, people out here now, and I'm tired of what they do, and we're going to do something about it. We're going to talk about no blood tonight. New York Times story. Read it, they say New York Times.
The methodology.
No, they say New York Times.
Yes, sir, it says New York Times.
Okay, and what do they say?
1.5 million missing black men.
Yes, they do it every night in New York. Yeah, you don't know about it. Every night. But you, anything is got to change. Okay, the thing I'm telling you is, we have to go in and dig this up. Read it again.
1.5 million missing black men.
Okay, every night. And you should be in our summer. So again, this big news again. What's it say?
National Black Market Body Parts being exposed in Michigan.
Okay, being exposed in Michigan. And you learned about what happened in Flint? Huh? Flint? The water? Okay, that's genocide. Nobody called it genocide. So the one black woman that couldn't get the gun to investigate, she came up to the federal court. And we three came along to talk about and the
And that's the picture that went around the world. Okay? When they show me coming out there, see all the stuff? My brother? Huh? They told me tonight. He come out, he had a flip-flop and sharp pants. 15 minutes later, he laying dead with lightning and law by himself. Okay? And y'all don't see that? Because my wife will show you, and you don't throw me there, you need to get your fist ball off and talk that word. You always hate to hear that stuff. And they can support, show you that, and all you got to do is go. And so, why, okay, he's praying Christ into the ocean. The white folks can give the autopsy, draw the pictures to me, and show me where they shot him in the head. That's a bullet hole in his head. He never was a plane, but in the ocean that they said he was. He is the tail of a plane, that looked like the ocean. This is what they do every day. And we all sit around talking all that crazy stuff about this. Who wants to talk about this? And so, how many people say, is this record?
1.5
million. And then another thing that came out of Washington Post, he told you where they are. Me and that family, where they are. Now, what the heck are they? In Washington Post, look at that.
It says, today's earth is a little less lonely. NASA announces the discovery of Kepler, 420.
That's what they call. So don't you know that? Stop looking for them. That's where they are. And there's no way you can get there, Father. How can you get there? I know how you get there. So, and as we wind down, we need to be here this evening. We need platforms to take education if we answer. This is the story about a nine with powerful rich men on the deck. It happened in Chicago. They gathered at the Edgewater Beach Hotel. This is what it says now, 1923.
The rise and fall of nine rich men. Money, as we know it, is neutral. It's neither evil nor bad. It's what we do with it that will make a difference in our lives. I read about this illustration recently. A popular story recounts a meeting that may have taken place at the Edgewater Beach Hotel in Chicago in 1923.
1923! Now, here's this, the reading story.
Yes, sir.
He's been touching. These are the nine most powerful white men on the planet. Number one,
Charles Schwab, president of the world's largest independent steel company.
That's U.S. Steel. Okay, number two,
Samuel Insull, president of the world's largest utility company.
Number three,
Howard Hobson, president of the largest gas firm.
Number four,
Arthur Cutting, the greatest wheat speculator.
Number five,
Richard Whitley, president of the New York Stock Exchange.
Number six,
Albert Fall, member of the President's Cabinet.
A billionaire. Number seven,
Leland Frazier, president of the Bank of International Settlements.
Number eight,
Jesse Livermore, the greatest speculator in the stock market.
Number nine,
Ivar Cooper, head of the company with the most widely distributed securities in the world.
In a row, that's nine. And then someone said, let's see what they're going on.
What happened to these powerful and rich men 25 years later? Charles Schwab died in bankruptcy, having lived in a borrowed money for 5 years before his death.
Number two,
Samuel Insull had died virtually hideous after spending some time as a fugitive from justice.
Number three,
Howard Hobson became insane.
Number four,
Arthur Cutting died overseas, broke.
Number five,
Richard Whitley has spent time in a mental asylum.
Number six, all of them that are hideous and broken, and the last three of them have committed suicide. So that's what he's doing. You think it's not. You want some people to go to school, get a good education, you make that. That works with the Catholic Church, the Baptist Church, and the universal God. I don't give a damn to your life and day to day. Thank you. And so, here's what we're going to do. When we look at that God, is that right? Okay? There's a group of national scientists, and I said this earlier, that form their own information bank to tell the world that the money they spend on Facebook was to chase this study. And here's the story here. 74 what?
74 top national scientists murdered in the past 10 years.
What's going on? This is the biggest cover up in the history of the planet. They were going to